Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we're going to talk about the Nonfiction on Booktube tag. And I suppose it's a horror edition because here we are, right? And that's really a lot of what I read. And that's really where a lot of my nonfiction goes. So a year ago or so, a book olive did this tag, Booktube Nonfiction tag, to kick off Nonfiction November. And I'm going to do some nonfiction reading this November because I've been sorely lacking. And I'm still kind of wrapping up some Gothtober reading. I wanted to get to a couple books. They'd been sitting on my TBR a little too long, and now is a great time to get to them. And I thought I'd start out instead of with a TBR for Nonfiction November, which is forthcoming. I'm going to do the Nonfiction Booktube tag, which was done recently by Triumphal Reads. So question one is, how much nonfiction do you read? Not enough, as I was just complaining that these books have been on my TBR for a little while. But then when I look through the scope of my years of reading, I read a lot of nonfiction. I like a lot of like true crime and history, bio, and a lot of like informational books on writing and writer's craft books. So I read about one book a month and maybe two, and I don't really talk about them on BookTube, right? So that's quite a bit of my reading that is nonfiction. Question two is, what kind of nonfiction videos do you make on BookTube, or do you want to make on BookTube? Now, I did do a little bit of writer's craft. I've covered a few writer's books on AuthorTube, and I should do a new one because I've got some new books in that realm, and I've done nonfiction vampire books. I will note that nonfiction vampire books is kind of a confusing term because vampires don't exist, right? Right. But there are nonfiction vampire books, not only literary books, but books to do with the taxonomy of vampires. And you can check out my nonfiction vampire book video if you're interested in that. But what I want to make, more true crime. I've said it before. If you're new here, welcome. Thank you. Subscribe. Hello. Leave some comments in the section below. And of course, if you have been here, you've heard me complain that I don't cover enough true crime books, or I'm reading true crime books and I don't talk about them often enough here on BookTube. But this month that's going to change. Question three is, what's your favorite subgenre of nonfiction? And this is a hard question. A lot of these are hard questions for me because I want to say true crime, but I read more literary flavored and author craft sort of books as well. And not all just how to hone your characters and viewpoint books, but books like The Ladies and Her Monsters, A Tale of Dissections, Real Life Dr. Frankenstein's, and The Creation of Mary Shelley's Masterpiece by Roseanne Montillo. This is the sort of book that really gets me going. It was a lightning fast read, no pun intended, and I really enjoyed the glimpse into Mary Shelley's world and the hard facts of Grimm's fairy tales. I am a big fairy tale reader. I love Grimm specifically, probably because of my German heritage, and this particular book, digging into the stories and where they came from, the Grimms themselves, very fantastic to me. Mary Roach's book Spook. Oh my gosh, more ghosts, please. Now, these aren't all true crime, right? Which is the first thing you might think of, which is horror adjacent, but these are horror adjacent, obviously, because of the literary fount, the other literary fount of the biggest monster we've ever met, and of course, ghosts. So I'd have to say that my favorite subgenre is horror nonfiction, however you want to define that. Number four is, do you have a favorite nonfiction book? And part of me wants to say Vincent Bugliosi's Helter Skelter about the Manson murders. I've read and reread that book a million times. That was my cottage book. Reading Helter Skelter and The Hobbit every summer was like a thing that I did. And that is my number one favorite book, but I'd have to say, once I saw it in my bookshelf when I was preparing to do this tag, this is my number one favorite nonfiction book, Ghost Towns of Ontario, A Field Guide. It is mangled. It's been in and out of the boot of a car a million times. It's been in the glove box. It's spattered with coffee and dirt and dust. I used to have some keepsakes from Kelsey, Ontario, a ghost town in here. It is something that I've actually used the way it ought to be used. So yeah, Ghost Towns of Ontario is my favorite nonfiction book. Question five is, what do you think keeps people from wanting to read more nonfiction? And a book olive really hit the nail on the head when she talks about this like weird stuffy gloominess, and that the personification of nonfiction is an old dude in his library with a sweater vest. And that's very, very true. I also think it's a real holdover from school. You read nonfiction in school. That's what school is. So when you leave school, you're like, blah, I don't want to read another textbook. I want to read escapism. I want fiction. I want fun. Fiction is fun. Nonfiction is not, right? It's non-fun, right? That's the holdover idea that many people have. And also, I think that nonfiction, people would think that it maybe doesn't offer the same escapism. You say, oh, I read books to relax. I don't want to think. Well, fiction makes you think, and fiction takes you on the exact same journey, if not a journey that you wouldn't otherwise get in fiction, you can only find in nonfiction. I can read Kundun or watch Kundun, but I can also read The Universe in a Single Atom by the Dalai Lama. And if you want a real journey, I think that a book like this offers a lot more than a quick bite of a movie does, where those are snacks and this is a meal. Question six is, why do you like nonfiction? And it could very well be just because my reading has always been quite balanced, and I've always turned to books first as a real rich primary source, other than the Cole's Notes version of something. I also think that I found with fiction, it sort of, the buck stopped there, right? And it sort of only offered what it offered between those two pages. And you can learn a lot in fiction, and you can take your reading beyond in fiction, but that is where the story lives and dies. Where in real life, you can get many different opinions on something, or different facets of something. You can read a lot of books on vampires, granted, sure. And you can also read all of Stephen King's books, but then you can read a book by Stephen King on the things he writes. And then you can read a book by Stephen King on the things he writes. Then you can read books on Stephen King. I think that the world of nonfiction is just so much more broad and offers just so much more than the fairly narrow world of fiction. And I need that. I also like the counterpart to fictional world so that I can explore both. I think I've always leaned on nonfiction when I want some really deep entertainment as well, and something that will be a little more thought-provoking, because that is what is very entertaining and interesting to me, more so than the small escapist break from reality. I want a long-form escapist break from my reality with somebody else's. I've always sort of wanted to write some long-form journalism, and that's probably also part of it, is having that lived experience. Long form is very interesting to me. What is a nonfiction book that you read because of BookTube? Story by Robert McKee. So many people recommended it. I've been following Regina's reading of it. I've been reading it in fits and starts. So many people recommend it that I can't not read it. What is the best nonfiction book you've read lately? Behind the Horror by Dr. Lee Meller. True stories that inspired horror movies. You can see, again, horror adjacent, but in a totally different tangent. We're talking about horror movies and true crime here. And it is a fascinating book. I'm not quite done it. This is part of my nonfiction November reading. And maybe not as recent, but one of the best nonfiction books I've read in a while is The Professor in the Cage by Jonathan Gottschall, Why Men Fight and Why We Like to Watch. And it's a really interesting study on the battle of the sexes, as it were. And I was also drawn in by this fantastic cover. Number nine is, what are some of your nonfiction reading goals? And that would be to read more modern true crime. A lot of my true crime books that I have available are older or encyclopedic. And that is to say they contain many different true crime stories in one. I haven't read a really good, rich, deep dive, and I'm not going to read The Devil in the White City, but something like that, that is just one story, a big, long, deep dive that's engrossing and maybe offer something new to the story. I would love to read something on the Phantom Murder, the Texarkana Moonlight Murders, or Zodiac stuff, because in my mind they're linked, that sort of stuff, or new true crime that I've never heard of before. And that was always the fun of a used bookstore true crime section to me, is I would be like, oh, I never heard about this freakish man who kept this dead body in his house for a decade because he loved her. Question 10 is, what is your advice for incorporating more nonfiction into your reading diet? And I would say follow your passions. My passion while writing the Night Face novel was thinking about dreams, and I read this fantastic book by James Hillman, The Dream in the Underworld, and it was just a real eye-opener as far as the historical thinking of nightmares and the linkage between the land of the dead and our nightmares and our psychology. It was just a fantastic read, and it's something that I've reread, and I just love this book. So that was my passion at the moment. My next real passion was Ottawa, living in Ottawa. I have a couple books about the area, and maybe you haven't read enough about the history of your area, and there's probably several books, and probably several books by people who are local authors, so you could probably meet and talk to them or hear them speak about their book if you're that interested. But this is about Ottawa's Notre Dame Cemetery, and it talks about the history of a lot of the cemeteries in this area. So I really, really enjoyed that, and I was devouring a lot of local history at the time, and the books definitely led me from one to the other. If you want really light, digestible fare as far as nonfiction, try magazines. Room Morgue Magazine, that's my most recent issue, and magazines are a great foray into nonfiction, and it's a little bit light. If you don't read enough nonfiction, maybe pick up a magazine. If you're into photography, pick up a photography magazine. Gaming, horror, whatever it is that strikes your fancy, the magazines may actually lead you to more nonfiction reads. Or if there's a giant passion in your life, maybe try and read something that is counter to that. If you like the Bible, try Everything You Know About God Is Wrong. And this is from the Disinformation Group, and they have a lot of these great big awesome tomes that are really interesting. There's probably something that would strike your fancy within their library. And of course, there are a zillion nonfiction books to choose from. So you can always choose something like, if you're a reader or a writer of fiction or horror, there's a lot of books that link into that. If you like to go on nature walks, there's probably books that can enhance that. If you've been interested in tea, there are many nonfiction books on tea ceremonies, or the way of the brush and tea, and the Art of War might even have something to tangentially link into there. So there's always going to be something within your passions, your current interests, or interests that you've had for your entire life that will link into some nonfiction book. And also take the fiction you're reading right now. If you're reading The Terror, read about the Franklin Expedition. If you liked the film Titanic, learn more about the actual tragedy. I think that that's really fantastic stuff to do. The bonus here is to give some shoutouts to other channels you follow that do nonfiction, and I don't really follow a lot. I follow Triumphal Reads. I follow Bookish. She talks about nonfiction quite often. I follow Rosanna Sunley, who talks about business books. But here and there, I mostly catch with booktubers that I typically follow that might mention a nonfiction book or podcast that they're watching, because I kind of count those in there too. If you know of some nonfiction booktube that is horror adjacent preferably, let me know in the comments below, or if you yourself have a nonfiction booktube channel that would be of interest to myself or anyone else watching, leave a link in the comments. That'd be awesome. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back soon enough with a TBR for Nonfiction November and a little wrap up from my October leftover, a little Halloween hangover. Thank you again, and have an ooky, spooky day.